Hi everyone, and welcome to the official video for Eren's Adventure Update 1.2. In this patch we have a lot of new things. Community requested options, settings, features. So here you see one of the new enemies added in this update. We tried to add a few more enemies. There are 5 new enemies to be precise. And they can be found mostly in the enemy camps. Not the bases, but the camps. And they are there to make those a little bit more challenging, basically, especially early in the game. That's going to be nice. Oh, so there's been some combat updates as well. Eren can now not be stunlocked anymore, and this changes depending on the difficulty that you play at. So if you play on easy, it's going to be very hard to get stunlocked, and if you play on challenge, you only get a small window of opportunity to get out. Now, we changed the lighting up a bit. Fog is now more clamped, so no more situations of excessive fog or excessive little fog. You can change the bloom settings as well. And the nighttime lighting has been changed a little bit. Something else, when we look on our map, we can see crafting encounters. So these are small groups of enemies that have crafting materials with them. And you can select those, like you can select rifts, making it a little bit easier to find where there's still something left for you to explore. Now I know there are those of you that don't like to see all these things. So if you go to the gameplay settings, you can see that you can hide the crafting encounter markers. You can also change the FOV up to 140, which looks absolutely ridiculous on my screen. But for those with a widescreen, that might be really nice. It was requested that we add those. So we've added those. Going to controls. We've made a lot of changes to the gamepad. So a lot of things have been fixed. A lot of bugs. We were able to find a bug related to rotation as well, which happened a lot on gamepad. So that's been fixed as well. You can now clearly see what buttons can be rebound for the gamepad. And all the way at the bottom, there are some controller specific inputs. Now, I did have to make some changes and some fixes. So for those of you that already did some rebinding, you may have to reset to default. And if that doesn't work, you can try a hard reset of the keybinds, which will require a game restart. And that's required in case you try to rebind something, but it doesn't let you, or it says any key, or it gives you like a dash. So that should help those of you out there that are affected by these changes. Otherwise, there's a sticky post on the community hub. So what else do we have? Lots of small fixes, communications, optimizations. There were the optimization wasn't especially in level 1, there was a lot more room for optimization. When we go to video options, like I said, you can now change the bloom multiplier. So if you think the bloom is too intense in a game, you can decrease that, and it should work throughout the game, most of the areas, if not all the areas. We've got DLSS, we already had that, but it's under NVIDIA now. We have ray traced ambient occlusion, it's a nice little detail, and we have RTX GI, it's NVIDIA's global illumination. It's currently, we're treating it as a beta because we're still implementing it, and it still has some artifacts here and there. Outside of that, everything is still the same. These two buttons have been swapped because we saw a lot of people returning to the main menu when they wanted to return to the game. It means that I keep returning to the menu, but a better, because I'm used to it the other way around, but better it be me than most of the people playing. So to those of you who are like me, I'm sorry. It was requested a lot, so. Oh. So you're able to stunlock enemies again, because we've made some changes to how many enemies can attack you at the same time, to make it a little bit more challenging. But that meant, especially in late levels where more enemies can attack you at the same time, it can get a little bit overwhelming for Eren. And it's nice that to stunlock your enemies. So if you hit your attacks at the right time, if you do critical damage, you'll be able to stunlock them. So yeah, like I said, we also have the aim multiplier. So when you're aiming, sensitivity multiplier. We also have new animations for with the bow, as you can see, look a lot better. At first he was hunched over for it a lot more, so we got people giving feedback about that. That's all I can think of right now. I'm gonna quickly check if I'm forgetting anything. Yeah, I suggest you check out the patch notes, lots of small stuff, lots of fixes, bug fixes, etc, etc. There will also be a sale, a 20% discount. During the open world sale, which Steam is having right now, probably. It's only for 3 days, 3 or 4 days, I think. And yeah, so, you know, if you still have it on your wish list and you were still on the fence about getting it, now could be a good time to get it. All right, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you'll have a blast with this update. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.